Sorry. Yeah, no, a fitness gym. So I'm a member over at the club, and I've been a member there probably about a year, and every time I go in, there's not a lot of people working out. I've never seen anybody go and sign up, and the owner's a really nice guy, so I went up and did a little guts. It was a little ballsy. It was something along the lines of, I think you have a problem, and kind of
Ooh.
smiled, looked around the gym, and he kind of peeked around too, saw no one was working out, and he's like, "Well, what's the problem?" He's like, "Well, you know what the problem is. I mean, there's no members here, nobody's working
What
out.
a
You have
oh, what a gut salesman you are. Good,
a
bravo. That's finding a
Right.
need, creating a need, exacerbating a need, and
Yep.
having the courage, the guts to approach somebody up front with a problem rather than do a whole bunch of, can I have a minute of your time, or are you busy right now? Just go for it. I love that. Bravo.
Right, thank you. Thank you. So, it went from there, and he asked what I had in mind, and I let him know my background from the fitness sales. I was the general manager over at the Crunch Fitness and had the experience there. And I let him know that, there's a way that he's able to increase his sales really just by getting better, with his outreach as far as, marketing business to business and really picking up the phone. And that's where he started opening up and admitting that he really didn't see himself as a good salesman. So asked what I would be able to do for him, and I let him know that if he would be interested or if the opportunity was there, I could do 1 month. And I told him that I could do 100 memberships for him strictly just by cold calling. I mean, getting big corporate accounts, so 20 members here, 30 members there. And he loved the idea, so we went for it. I wanted to get 7,500 up front, but he wasn't willing to do that, so we got it down to 6 grand. But I mean, that's more money than I ever made at Crunch Fitness in 1 month
Wow, wait a
since I
second. You
had
made
them.
$6,000 by just talking to a stranger?
Yes, sir.
First
Yes.
time you ever utilized this idea with this person?
Yeah, first time. Well, like I said, I was a
Oh.
member for about a year, so I've seen the guy there, but that was the
Okay.
first time I ever approached. That's the first time I had the balls to actually go up and do it. So
Good for
that went
you,
really.
man. Good for you.
Thank you so much.
Can I use this little 3-minute segment here and share it with a few people?
You sure can.
Okay, because it kind of motivates other people when they hear the success of just using your words the right way. I'm always beating the drum about sales and using the right words and motivating other people and creating interest. And you went right for his gut with basically greed. Hey, you need to make more money. You got a problem here. I have a solution for you. Boom, boom, boom.
Right,
Look at
right.
that.
Yeah, so that was all February. It was literally, I don't, I think it was February 2nd was when that was all set. That's when I got paid from him. So right from February 2nd, I hit the ball running on the phones. And really the biggest accounts that I closed was one company's called MultiQuip. And I was able to get 50 memberships out of there at $30 a month. And this is a 24-month agreement too, so I mean, that guy had that one, and then the biggest account I was able to close was 80 memberships at HP, which is like 5 minutes from where the location
Hewlett
is.
Packard.
Yes.
Okay, well, good. So I'm sensing a different rhythm here. A different. Your big focus is real estate, but do you see yourself maybe specializing in using your gut skills in something that you have a background in, or?
Honestly, Claude, because I do have a real estate deal that I did do in February too that'll run by you, but I love the gym, I really do, and I kind of just wanted to throw it. I didn't think the guy would say yes, so
Can't hurt
I
to
figured,
ask, right?
yeah, so I just figured I'd ask, and it worked out. And I didn't actually have to go to the location really. I mean, I just worked the phones from my own house and was able to just call those big businesses and talk to the right people and display guts, so that worked really
There
well
you
there.
go.
Yeah, so that went really good for the month of February, and obviously it was just for the month of February, and we actually are going to meet this Saturday. The gentleman's name is Mark. He's the
Okay.
owner, and so I'm going to meet with Mark and
Are you going to write a
go over the
contract?
numbers, how everything
Are you going
went.
to put it in writing?
I would like to see something, long term. I definitely would, but I love doing the lease options. Like this whole month of March is kind of I wanted to dedicate it to the real estate. So I mean,
Okay.
I've only done one deal. I didn't sandwich lease it. It was an assignment, but really great house. It was 350,000, and I got a $7,500 assignment fee. And it took me maybe 3 days, 4 days to get that deal.
That's all right, too. It's all money. What is your takeaway from the gym that you can apply to your real estate business? Because it's all the same thing, but there's something there that you did. It's spectacular, different, innovative, creative. What's your takeaway from the gym that you can apply to real estate?
My biggest takeaway is it was an in-person, you know, conversation. Typically, I mean, you know, obviously all the other sales were made over the phone, but this was the first time I've actually walked up to some. I mean, keep in mind, I did, you know, decently know the guy, but I've never actually walked up to a person and made something happen like that, to where I was able to get a 1 month little consulting gig and get some memberships through the door and make them some money.
What's my rule?
So that was my big stake.
Yeah. Right? What's my rule of five?
Five new people a day.
Yeah. All you got to do is talk to people. If you talk to enough people and use your gut skills, like you obviously just did, you cannot help but succeed. And this is where we've gotten away from this for some reason. We think we can automate a business. I'm not against automation by any means, but I think we're losing our skill set to just learn how to just communicate with another human being and say, you got a problem. I have a solution. How would you like to see this happen? How would you like to make more money? How would you like to sell your house in 30 days, buy a house in 30 days? We've lost that ability to initiate positive conversations with people, adult-to-adult conversations with people. We've lost that skill set. Maybe we're just texting too much or something.
Right.
I don't know what it is. I can tell you right now, my business succeeds because I have absolutely no hesitation in picking up that phone and talking to people all day long. Do people say no to me? Absolutely. Every day people say no to me. They're not allowed to say I'll think about it, because you know what I do with that. They're not allowed to say I'll talk to their wife, because I handle that too. But it's a different way of selling, and I think the most important thing is your confidence level was so high. You took the emotion out of it, and you were your own cheerleader. You said, hey, let me talk to this guy. I got a good idea. I know what I'm talking about. He can say no. He can say, get out of my gym. He can reject me. He can lie and manipulate me, but I'm going to give it a try. Anyway, if you don't try, you don't even get the chance. What's the old thing with the lottery ticket? You got to play to win. You know,
something like that.
Okay,
yeah.
Well, the odds are so much better in direct sales. They're so much better than they are than you'll ever find in a Las Vegas casino or buying a lottery ticket.
Right.
I'm just a problem solver. I'm the doctor of real estate. That's what I want you to be. Find a problem. Is that problem great enough? On a 1 through 10, the barometer. If it's an 8, 9, 10, piece of cake. Okay, because they're emotionally involved. If they're a 4, 5, 6, you've got to stimulate it a little bit. Yeah, maybe tell some stories or metaphors or experiences you have that'll get them to more like you, trust you, and get them up to an 8, 9, 10. If they're a 1, 2, or 3, you have to be very creative. You have to invent some new needs, some new greeds, or you get to fire them, and get practice, get a lesson. Either way, you grow as a gut salesperson. And when you feel confident enough, you have no hesitation to speak to enough people. The simplest thing I can say to people is, can you speak to 5 people a day? Not try to talk, not make 5 phone calls, but can you speak to 5 people a day? And you'll see some unbelievable magic happen. It's just putting the math, the algorithms,